Good morning. Welcome to the Oregon Fly Fishing Blog. Tony Torrance here. We're going to tie a series of trout patterns over the next few days. Hope you enjoy all these new flies. Good morning. This morning we're going to tie a Renee Harrop Bubbleback Caddis. It's a very cool pattern. Great emerger for your caddis hatches. We're going to sub some materials. We're not going to use Renee's dubbing. We're going to use a little bit of STS Trilobal Tan for our shuck. So I'll just get a few strands of this. Keep this pretty fine. We have a shuck there. Now we need some wood duck for our tail. That in. You can do the wood duck first, and I think actually I normally do it that way, but we have our tail in. So now I need some CDC, and I'll just pull it out away and then strip each side of the feather. So now we'll tie in our CDC. Sure, it's going to reach over and make a decent bubble first. Next, we'll dub a little bit of STS Trilobal. This is a very coarse dubbing, so just use a light amount. And you could change your thread color to brown too. I'm using black or a tan thread would work well. You got to get enough dubbing to cover the thread, but don't make the body too thick. You want to keep this, you know, real thin like an emerger would look. I didn't do a very good job of it. We're going to go with it. Okay. Two ways to do this hackle. You can use a partridge and just wrap it around, or you can tie it in a throat style. I am going to do a throat style just because it's easier for me. To get the hackle underneath where it should be instead of having it on top of the fly. All I'm going to do is take my feather, strip it back a little bit, notch a V in here, and I'll take these fibers and lay them downward. I don't know if you can see that with my fingers in there. But that V, I'll put the top of the V right on top of the feather, or on top of the fly. And then get these fibers to come down underneath like a throat. And then I'll shorten them just by pulling a little bit until I get them exactly where I want them in length. Bring the bubble over. Kind of spread your bubble a little. See a few fibers broke loose? That's okay. That just gives it a buggier look. Let me trim up this head a little bit first. And for the head, we'll be using some Senyo Laser Dub in a dark tan. Just need a little bit of this. A little goes a long way. This stuff dubs pretty tight, so it's nice to use. We'll put a little whip finish on this fly. and you have a bubble back.